Hey, it's Becky. Here's a quick tutorial for making a 3D printed adapter to connect your power tools to your shop vac if they're not naturally compatible. Let's get started. You'll need a set of digital calipers to measure your tools and a 3D printer. I'm using Tinkercad to design this part because it's free and extremely easy to use. For this example, I'll be using my own Ryobi planer and sander and my Festool shop vac hose, but these general instructions should work for any two tubes you have that are close to the same size as each other. You'll need to take four measurements: the outside diameter of the tool's dust outlet, the outside diameter of the hose terminal, and the length of each of those as well. Keep in mind that these openings are usually tapered to allow for a snug press fit, so the outside diameter measurement might not be the same along the length of the tube. I tried to take a measurement somewhere in between the smallest and the largest, and you'll inevitably need to do a bit of experimenting with the tolerance to get a good fit anyway. Once you have your measurements, it can be helpful to make a paper sketch. This can help you remember which measurement is which when you get into the 3D design environment and help you keep track of adjustments you make during prototyping. Opening up a new Tinkercad file, you'll create a cylinder to start. Match the height to the overall height of your coupler, then change the diameter to 2.2 millimeters greater than your largest port measurement. Next, create a cylindrical hole and set its dimensions to match that of your smaller tube. Increase the diameter by 0.2 millimeters to allow it to fit over the tube, that's your tolerance, and create another cylinder atop the first one with dimensions matching your larger tube plus 0.2 millimeters. You can use the work plane tool to rest the second cylinder exactly atop the first. Then select all three objects and use the Align tool to line them up on the X and Y axes. Finally, group the objects to cut out the hole. You should end up with a single tube whose opening changes sides inside. All that's left to do is export the STL and slice it. I used Cura and set the print quality to low since this is a utilitarian tool and does not need to have a pristine surface finish. The first version took about 35 minutes to print on my Creality CR10S Pro. If at first the result doesn't fit or it's too flimsy, it's easy to go back into your Tinkercad design and make changes. Double-click on a grouped object to drill down into the group. I adjusted the thickness of the adapter walls by enlarging the main cylinder to make the whole thing a little more sturdy, and made a minor adjustment to one of the inner cylinders to get a better fit. The second and final version took about an hour and a half to print. It fits great and it feels pretty sturdy in PLA, although it would probably be more durable in something like nylon filament instead. If you want the step-by-step or the file for my Ryobi Festool adapter, head over to the link in the description. There's a similar video by Bob Claggett about making an angled adapter to connect his stationary tool to dust collection using Fusion 360, and I'll link his video in the description. Thanks so much for watching. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe with the bell to be notified of my future uploads. Let me know what you'd like to see next in the comments. You can connect with me on Twitter and Instagram, and also sign up for my email newsletter. See you next time.